Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, I'm going to show you advanced conditional formatting, meaning I'm going to have Excel functions inside my conditional formatting. A couple weeks ago, I made a video on getting started with conditional formatting. That video is down in the description. It is also up in the top right corner. If you don't know conditional formatting, please watch that one first. But let's dive in to advanced conditional formatting. So I've got, this file will be available for you after this video. So I want to make sure that everyone in the state of Georgia shows up in a certain font color. I showed you this last week. Great, I'm going to undo that. I want to select the entire row though, not just column E. So step one of conditional formatting, highlight your range. So I started in A2. Went to cell J21, conditional formatting, that equal to that I just used is no good. We're going to write a rule, new rule. All three examples that I'm doing today are going to have a formula. So use a formula. If you notice, the question is, where is Georgia located? That's the state. It is in column E. So my formula is going to be equals $ E2 equals GA. I did put GA in double quotes. Go to format. How do you want this to look? I'm going to do a yellow fill color. Hit OK. When I hit OK, there we go. Let's give it a quick test. This San Diego is incorrect. This person's actually in Georgia. And there we go right there. So that is example number one. Let's go to example number two. I'm going to do example two and example three using the average worksheet. So again, last week I showed you, I want to see purchases to date over the average. That was top and bottom rules above average. Notice there are four numbers over the average. That's okay. The issue I have with that is, what is the average? So I'm going to come over here and do the average function for purchases to date. Average is 1651. Conditional formatting, again, the same rules apply. Select first, new rule, and use a formula. Haven't changed that one. So the formula, I'm trying to see if cell H2, because that's the first cell that I have selected, is greater than N1. So equals, I don't know if mixed reference is needed here. I'm going to just throw it in here. But I know for N1, absolute reference is needed. So it's H2 is greater than N1 is definitely absolute reference. I press the F4 function key. Format, I'm going to stick it in green. I don't care what color you use. There are those four numbers again, and I can see that the average is over 1651. Quick little tip, if you remember, if you highlight a range down in the status bar, there is my average right there. Cool little feature, you may not know this. If you click on that 1651, click somewhere else and do Control V, it will actually paste that number on the screen. But notice it's not a formula. I just wanted to show you that cool tip. The reason I like this is this reason. If I come in here and start tweaking numbers, this number is 1803 or 1802, I don't care. It picks it up. Notice the average changed over there to the left. One more. 1900, again, it is working. Last one, I want to know who has the maximum income equals max. Write this formula wherever you want to. So there's my formula in the formula bar right up there. Equals max I2 through I21. Well, I don't want to sit here and try to find that number in this range of numbers. I could go sort it largest to smallest and see it, but I don't even want to do that. So I'm going to highlight the range. You know where we're headed. New rule. Formula. The first cell I got selected is I2, to be real clear about that. Equals I2, equals the max of I2 to I21. And we need to make I2 to I21 absolute cell reference. Let's do that again. F4, F4. Go to format, pick a color. Orange works this time. Only one number, the highest number, should be in orange. Let's test it. I'm going to change this number, 84,000, to 127,500. It should change down below where I did the max function, and it should pick up the orange, and it did. There are three examples that I just did on why I love to use functions with conditional formatting. This file will be available for you to download and run through here, and I'll even keep the answer sheets also in here in case you get stuck. Have a great day. Feel free to subscribe. Thank you for your time.